Now it's time for yet another turn in the Fornax sector. And on this turn, I have this mission here. Unload all freighters, so all the freighters and all the ships. It means all your ships, and it will unload all your cargo room from there. No torpedoes or no fighters, but all the minerals and money. And as you can see, I've got now quite a plenty of minerals and money on my homeworld. So now I will start to build these a bit bigger warships. I'm now first building these superstar cruisers, and these are simply needed because I already have a cat's paw and a nebula that are closing in from the left. So with superstar cruiser, I should be able to defeat such light warships. The battle between a cat's paw and a superstar frigate would be too even for my liking. So I will build a superstar cruiser for mobile intercepting those small flimsy ships. And perhaps I'm able to build something next turn too. On this planet, I will continue building this medium displaced fractor. These medium displaced fractor I will use to colonize these planets and build infrastructure there. This one goes there. This one goes there. Well, it took everything. And this one waits here. So we will get some more. Let's overtax them a bit. I don't care if they no. As I recall, you don't get tax money if you tax them too much. Okay, let's keep it that way then. Well, then the last freighter can just take clans forward. Okay, it will wait. If there will be natives on the other planet, it can bring clans there so they can tax. Okay, that's a compromise. This will continue its retribution against the enemy. This is the new captured planet. Now you can see my friendly codes, but usually the best practice after you have conquered a planet is that you click once the friendly code so it becomes randomized, so the enemy can't utilize that. And then, as I don't have anything here, I will double check it. Ready. And this medium freighter will take some precious money back home. And this let's try this one, if it helps. Like this. And then On this planet, I can't tax them anymore because they don't give money. So I will pick up the clans, supplies too, and the money. Actually, I pick up the clans and I will tow that other ship with me, the defense ship, and the defense ship will build some more torpedoes and lay mines there, small minefields. And so this will this losses breaker will bring those clans there to tax some more. And now on this planet, the happiness can grow. And of course, I need to pick up the money too. But so, as you can see, even though there are now more mines than what that population can hold, the amount of mines diminishes very slowly. And they will continue to dig just as well materials, resources from the planet. There's not much resources left underneath the surface. And this will continue here to build mines. And now my large D-space practice, both of them can try to tow one of these defense ships. Okay, let's build some supplies so I can get some torpedoes to each of them. Now I've got some torpedoes in each of my sacrificial ship. And now this will tow one of those freighters with it as a bodyguard, and it has got mission kill, so if somebody intercepts or comes to the same place. And now I should just choose from where I will go to pick some minerals and resources. That would be a good planet. There are plenty of minerals, and there's also next to it. So I'll go there, and I think I'll have to take some clans with me, because that nasty Falcon is doing that rebel ground attack over there. So I need to pick up some clans there. But this means I need to have a lot of neutronium. And now this will also tow another defense ship with it. But now this should go to some other planet that has plenty of resources. There's some, yay, but not enough. There's some coming, but let's go there, because that amount of molybdenum is quite high. Like this. And now this medium D-space freighter can go there to pick up some molybdenum back home. And this will stay here, because next turn there will be a superstar cruiser and it can tow this to the front. Okay, so now I'm getting somewhere again. And this sad planet, you can see that the population is, my clans are becoming very unhappy because the rebel ground attack is causing them to go to civil war. And it's a very bad thing. And the nuke doesn't help, the Ferengon nuke, because Rebel has got the immunity, the ships can't be attacked by the planets. The same is with the fascists. I will continue here my taxation. It doesn't even need to be very heavy because the but I will build some factories there and some defense and also those mines like that. I will take the money back home. And three planets left. The home world, the neighboring Gipsaldal, and this funny place. Let's build max factories and max mines and a little bit more defense. Like that. Okay, and that was yet another 10. Thank you.